many students, so many forms and so many questions. I'm not understanding. These are the questions arising in your mind. Here is the simple way to understand and remember the concept very easily and gain confidence so that you're going to present in your exam very well. Shall we start, children? This video I am going to give you some important concepts of carbon and its compounds. This video we shall learn about carbon and its compounds. In that you are going to learn about homologous series, alkenes, alkenes and alkynes, and IUPAC nomenclature. What do you mean by homologous series? Homologous series is a group of organic compounds having similar structure and similar properties. So what are homologous? Homo means same. So homologous series is a group of organic compounds having similar structures and similar properties. And these series differ by CH2 group.
Take for example, methane
and ethane. These belong to a homologous series of alkanes. So alkanes are nothing but they are the hydrocarbons. Okay. So in alkanes, you have methane and ethane. So if you take methane and ethane, methane formula is CH4. Ethane is C2H6. So if you see the difference, methane has only one carbon atom. Ethane has two carbon atoms. And hydrogen is 4 in case of methane. And in ethane, it is H6. So if you see the difference, one carbon atom and two hydrogen atom. So in every series, in every homologous series, we can see the difference will be of one carbon atom, two hydrogen atoms. Now we shall see homologous series of alkanes. Homologous series of alkanes. So what are alkanes? Alkanes are hydrocarbons. Alkanes are hydrocarbons, and these alkanes are having single bond. Single covalent bond is formed between the alkenes. So if you see the general formula for alkenes is CnH2n+2. This is the general formula of alkenes. CnH2n+2. So if you take, for example, if you take N as 1 H2 into 1 plus 2, you get C as 1 H2 into 1 is 2 plus 2, you get CH4. So this is the first group of alkanes, we call it as methane. So you have to know, children, alkanes, anes. So if one carbon atom is present, we call it as meth, M-E-T-H, meth, and we add ane to it. So methane or methane we call. And in the same way, if one carbon atom, we call it as meth. If two carbon atoms, we call eth. Three carbon atom, we call prop. Four carbon atom, we call bute. But we'll write, but we pronounce it as bute. Five carbon atom is called pent. Six carbon atom is called hex. Seven carbon atom is called 7-hept. Eight carbon atom we call it as oct. Nine carbon atom we call non. 10 carbon atom we call dec. So this is how we name the compounds, children. So if an hydrocarbon has two carbon atoms, we call it as eth. And if it is a alkane, how do you know a given compound is alkane? So alkanes are saturated hydrocarbons. So what are saturated hydrocarbons? Saturated hydrocarbons are the hydrocarbons which have single bond, carbon carbon single bond. So the two carbon atoms are connected with the single bond. If they have single bond, we call them as saturated hydrocarbons. What we call saturated hydrocarbons. So alkanes are saturated hydrocarbons with single bond. If they have single bond, we call them as alkanes. Now if that single bond, for example, if you can take ethane. So how do you write ethane now? How I told you the general formula CnH2n+2. If you take C as two carbon atoms, H 2, you know the formula, N is 2 plus 2. So C2H4 plus 2 C2H6. So ethane is C2. If carbon atoms are 2, then we call it, and if the single bond is present between them, we call ethane. So we call it as ethane. So how do you write the structural formula? 2 carbon atom and 6 hydrogen atoms are connected to the carbon atom. So if you can see the structural formula, you can see a single bond. If this is formed, a single bond is formed between the 2 carbon atom, we call it as ethane. And then same way you can write for propane. If 3 carbon atoms are there, C3. And I told you, one of the important characteristics of homologous series is they differ. Every series differ with 1 carbon atom, 2 hydrogen atom. So here you have ethane C2. So then you have the next prop C3. 1 carbon atom, 2 hydrogen atom will be extra. So C3H8 is propane. Then what about butane? C4H10 is butane. C5H12 is pentane. So this is how you are going to write the alkanes, children. So methane is CH4, ethane is C2H6, propane is C3H8, butane is C4H10, pentane is C5H12, 6H14 is hexane. Hexane. 6 carbon atoms, so we call it as hex. And because of single bond, if you write the structural formula, 6 carbon atoms with the hydrogen atoms, 14 hydrogen atoms, you can easily name this hydrocarbons, children, by counting the number of carbon atoms. So you have 6 carbon atoms. And because single bond, we call it as ane. And because 6 carbon atom, it is called hex. You all understood, children? So this is called hexane. The next group of homologous series, alkenes. Alkenes. So what are alkenes? Alkenes are unsaturated. These are unsaturated hydrocarbons with double bond, connected or with double bond. So we can see carbon with double bond. If a double bond is present between the 2 carbon atoms, we call them as alkenes. And not only that, we call them as unsaturated. If there is single bond, we call them as saturated. Unsaturated hydrocarbons have double bond as well as triple bond. But here alkenes are identified with double bond. For example, we can take examples. Before that, we will know what is the formula for writing alkenes. That is CnH2n. This is a general formula for alkenes. So if you can take NS2, if you take NS2, H2 into 2. So if you take C2H4. So I told you already, if 2 carbon atoms are present, we call it as eth. So this is eth. And we call it as, these are enes. So alkenes. So we call it as ethene. Alkenes, ethene. If they have 3 carbon atoms and with 2 carbon atoms, hydrogen atoms difference, that is 6, we call it as propene. And 4 carbon atoms with 2 hydrogen atoms differ. See here, ethene, C2H4, propene. See the number of carbon atoms, children. 2 carbon atom, ethene. 3 carbon atom propene, 4 carbon atom butene. And how do you find whether it is ene or ane? So you have double bond. If you take carbon atoms, double bond with hydrogen atoms. So here double bond is present, that's why we call it as ene. And for propene, 3 carbon atoms with the double bond between them. In propene, 3 carbon atom between 2 carbon atom if there is a double bond. Double bond and with the hydrogen atoms, that is 6 hydrogen atoms. We call it as propene with the double bond. Double bond is present, that's why we call it as propene. So, if in the hydrocarbons, if a double bond is present, you first count the number of carbon atoms, children, 1, 2, 3. So, 3 is prop and double bond is present, that's why we call it as ene. Now, we shall see the next homologous series, that is alkynes. Alkynes. So, what are these alkynes? Alkynes are also unsaturated hydrocarbons. They are also unsaturated hydrocarbons with triple bond. You have to remember, children, with triple bond between the two carbon atoms. Between the two carbon atoms. So now you all understood, children. So alkynes are also unsaturated hydrocarbons with triple bond between the two carbon atoms. So for example, you already know C2 means you have to say 2 carbon atom, you have to say ith. And what is the general formula for this alkenes? So CN H2N minus 2. CN H2N minus 2. So if you take N as 2, H2, 2 minus 2. So C2 H4 minus 2, C2 H2. So the ith is C2. And first group of alkenes is C2H2. So what do you call it as? Ethyne. So ethyne. You'll understood, children? Ethyne. So how do you know it is ene group or alkyne group? So you have to, if you see the structural formula, you can see triple bond and hydrogen atom. So, if there is a triple bond between the carbon and carbon atom, we call it as alkynes and ethyne. 2 carbon atom, ethyne. Then what is the next? C3. C3. 1 carbon atom you are adding extra and there is a difference of 2 hydrogen atoms. So, 4. C3. H4. What do you call? Propyne. Propyne. So, C, between 2 carbon atom, you can see the triple bond. Between 2 carbon atom, you can see the triple bond. And you can see there is link of hydrogen atoms. So, this we call it as propyne. Propyne. Like that, in the same way, you can have C4H6. That is C. Triple bond and you can see there is link of hydrogen atoms, 6 hydrogen atoms. You can see there is link of 6 hydrogen atoms. So this we call it as what? It's because of triple bond we call it as ene, and 4 carbon atom butyne. Now we shall learn about IUPAC system or IUPAC nomenclature. What is this IUPAC nomenclature? IUPAC nomenclature is the system of naming the hydrocarbons. Like every one of us or most of us have two names. One name at home and the other name at school. In the same way, organic compounds also have two names. Common names and official names. These official names only we call them as IUPAC nomenclature. So, what do you mean by IUPAC? It is International Union of pure and applied chemistry. Pure and applied chemistry. So this is a nomenclature or the naming system for hydrocarbons. So we shall see now how, based on this nomenclature, how are we naming the hydrocarbons. For example, methane. If I say methane, so children, methane, meth means one carbon atom will be there, and CH4 is called methane. So how do you name this, how do you call this as methane? Is so one carbon atom having four hydrogen atoms. So we can see here there is a single bond here. There is a single bond. That's why. And one carbon atom we call meth, and it is having single bond. We call it as ane. Single bond, I told you, ane. Double bond is ene. Triple bond is ine. So here single bond, that's why methane. You can even take one more example, children, for C2H6. So how do you write the structural formula? C, six hydrogen atoms you are going to write. So two carbon atoms, I told us eth. Two carbon atom is eth and single bond ane. So ethane. Okay children, you tell me children, if I write C5H12, what is this compound? C5 is what? Pentane. Penta. 5 is penta with 12 hydrogen atoms. Penta it is. So what you call it as? Pentane. Pent. 5 means pent. And because it is having single bond, it is called ane. Pentane. Now we shall name one more compound, children, C2H4. What is this? See, you, if you write the structural formula, C2 with a double bond, four hydrogen atoms are linked to the carbon atoms. So you tell me, children, now what is this compound? Yes, very good. Because two carbon atom, it is eth. And because double bond, it is ene. Very good. Ethene. Now we shall see one more example, children. C3H6. So how do you write the structural formula? Three atoms of carbon with a triple bond. With a double bond. Double bond. Having six carbon atom. Two. And here one hydrogen. And you have here one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and here was 6. So if you write, this is double bond. So because it is double bond and having 3 carbon atoms, so 3 carbon atoms is prop, and having double bond, so ene, propene. See one more example, C3H4. What is this compound? C3 carbon atoms with triple bond in between, one hydrogen atom here, total 4. So C3. So C3, what you call it as? Prop. And triple bond, ine. Propine. I hope you have understood how to write the names of the compounds, children. In the next video, I'm going to explain you about functional groups and some of the important applicable based questions which are really helpful for your exam. Thank you. See you next video.